Welcome to St. Elizabeth of Hungary Parish. On behalf of our congregation, I'd like to thank you for joining us for our Sunday Twilight Music Vespers. You can feel at home even during this quarantine. Aside from silence, that which truly comes closest to expressing the inexpressible is music. St. Elizabeth's offers a quiet, contemplative place to truly take in great classical music. Really, the best way to hear and to enjoy superb classical music performed by world-renowned virtuosos is in the context of a short liturgy, which we will provide for you here. Thank you. Please enjoy.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that he might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe is condemned already, because he had not believed in the name of the only Son of God.
I don't know what this region means to others. It is my birthplace, though now ringed with flames. A little land, my long lost childhood's world. I grew up from this tree trunk, a frail twig. My corpse, I hope, will rest beneath this soil. Here, I am at home. The bowed shrub at my feet, I recognize the flower and know its name. I know the road and those who come and go. I know too what the summer sunset means, with reddening pain poured out from sweating walls. This region for the airmen is just a map. He does not know here Vörösmarty lived. For him, it's factories and barracks. But for me, it is crickets, oxen, church towers, and gentle farmsteads. He, through his sights, sees chimneys and plowed up fields. I see the workmen trembling for their toil. Woods, birds in orchards, vineyards and graves, by one of which a grand dame noiselessly weeps. From what up here is a target railworks, down here is the dwelling of the signalman. We see him standing here in front of it, red flag in his hand, around him children. A sheepdog in the workyards frolicking. Nearby is a park, with footprints of past loves and kisses, honey sweet or bilberry sour. The years I went to school, I often stepped for luck on one stone in the sidewalk's edge when fearing classroom tests. Here is that stone. From far above, it cannot well be seen, no instrument able to detect it. Like other nations, we have greatly sinned. We know our sins, know when and how we sinned. But innocent are poets, laborers, and babies whose intelligence must shine, hidden away, protected in dark cellars, till peace once more its sign writes on our land. Then they, with fresh and open speech, will answer our stifled words. But shield us until then with your huge wings, O watching clouds of night.
Thank you. Just a week after Pentecost, a week after we experienced the flow of the Spirit. And today we are celebrating the Trinity, the Holy Trinity. It is what we always describe as a mystery. We always acknowledge how difficult to speak about it, but in a way just very, very easy. What the Trinity does mean for us, that God is love. God is a communion of love, a shared love. We have two wonderful descriptions of that in today's readings. The first, from the book of Exodus, that is the experience of Moses. He described God this way. He is a God who is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, merciful and gracious. And what he found, what he experienced as a prophecy, it does happen in the case of Jesus. So how he does describe this experience, speaking to Nicodemus, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life, to be saved. Jesus experiences a flow of love that can transform the world. The question for today is, whether do you need it? Whether do you desire this flow of love? Whether you are open to receive it into your life. Thank you.